Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
I'm going to tell you something that that really, how do I put it, which has been a part of my life. Okay, it has really been a part of my life. By the way, let me know if this cricket noise is really irritating you, because I sometimes get irritated, but I don't know if it irritates you. I can use a software to dim the noise at the background, but then just give me the feedback. Okay, having said that, let's move on with the video. Okay, what was I saying? Yeah, so right from a small age, as a young man, like all of us, we all like to be popular with friends, we all like to have friends, we all like appreciation, we all like to have a group that we can play with. Now, right from the time I was a small boy, I was very unpopular. People didn't like me very much. And the reasons are obvious. One is, I was socially awkward. I didn't know how to fit into groups. I always loved seeking attention, which you can make out. I was always talking too much. I love talking. Oh my goodness, I see so much of myself in my daughter, you know. It's so funny. She also talks. Like, she'll put on the YouTube video where she's learning, and she's actually talking to the channel, and she's singing, and sometimes when she's playing, she's talking, and I don't know what she's... So it reminds me of myself, like, you know. She's a very imaginative person, like, because, you know, she does all these ee-oo-ee and talking, and she comes to me and gives me the doll and tells me, give her mum that food, you know, so, and she'll give me a plastic small little thing, I have to feed the thing. So, yeah, I've always been talkative, always wanted attention, and on top of that, my parents were never supportive, they never took me out. They never let me have friends. They never mixed with other people. So I was locked up in the house, and my freedom was school. So there I would be mad, crazy, act like an idiot. So I was a very mischievous kid. Now, the one thing was, because I was this way, nobody liked me. Nobody wanted to hang around with me. Nobody wanted to play with me. And that... that kind of bugs you, but as a small kid, you don't give up. You still feel, oh, okay, no problem, he doesn't like me, I will try again and again and again. So it was always the case. Now, the funny thing is, this characteristic of my personality continued towards from school to high school to my work life. And it has been a reality even today. You'll be very shocked to know, even today, people don't like me. People don't like me. Oh, check this out. A snail. You see this snail? Hey, snail. Okay, let's get you. I think you want to go there. Okay. I just threw it out. Sorry, I didn't throw it out. But I guess it wants to be near the soft sand. Okay, so even today I'm not very popular. Now I'm pretty sure you'll be surprised. Surprised because I'm a public figure. Oh, it's raining. Oh no. I'm a public figure. I have so many followers. I look like a snake. I have so many followers. I have so many groups. I have so many, you know, fans and admirers. Now this is because of the role that I play. I play a role as a public personality. I play the role as a coach. We all wear, like this, you know, you wear different hats. You're a father, you're a husband, you're a friend, you're a coach, you're a working class professional, you're a businessman. So there are different hats that I wear. So as a businessman, you don't keep friends, just have people. As a husband, you don't care about the world. As a father, it only matters to you with your children. So as a coach and public personality, I have a few admirers. I have a few people who look up to me, who follow me, whether it's youngsters, old people, whatever. But now as a human being, as a person, minus the money, minus the intelligence, or if you can call that, minus the skill or expertise, as a normal person, when I interact with other people, there are only two things that happen. Either I don't like them because I find what they're talking is stupid or dumb or whatever, or they don't like me. Now, things that I don't like smoking, drinking, alcohol. I don't like this dancing. I find that very stupid. I think, like, what is all this? It's not my cup of tea, basically. And then when people talk, the problem is, this is what I've discovered, people just generally talk within their limited preview, within their limited knowledge, and it's always nonsense. It's rubbish. Like, for example, let's say I were, check any WhatsApp group. Okay, check any WhatsApp group. What will the guy talk? The guy will give you his opinion about, say, the COVID situation. Oh, you know what the fuck, yeah, this government is that, and a lockdown is this, and so you'll just keep rambling here and there. In fact, I'll give you a good example. Go to a tea shop, see the people sitting around, groups. You'll always see a group of people working, colleagues or whatever, whether it's laborers or it's bricklayers or bankers. They'll just be talking nonsense, nothing productive. So I find it a total waste of time, because even if you spend 1 hour, 3 hours, 6 hours, or you spend years, you're not going to grow as an individual. So I find it real stupid. So that's me. Now, with regards to individuals, I think they find me overbearing because my attention-seeking persona is there. You know, my tattoos and all that, so that always obviously makes me kind of the weird one out. I talk too much. I like to dominate a conversation. And even if I'm a listener, I'm very selective. I don't like to listen to nonsense. So if I find someone talking nonsense, I'll say, thanks very much, bye-bye, you know. Or politely, like, I'll not say, bugger off. So as a normal guy, I've never been popular. Okay. And surprisingly, to my big surprise, even on Facebook, even on social media, whenever I put a comment or whenever, even there also I found out I'm not very liked. So I've realized that this part of my personality will remain forever. I'll always be unpopular. I'll always be, you know, not liked by people. Now, as a youngster, it used to really bother me a lot. I would try my level best to be liked by people. I would try to be sweet. I would try to be nice. I would try to, you know, do stuff that would make people like me. But it never worked. You know, it just never worked. It's getting louder now. So now, my main point is, now what do you do? What do you do if you're not liked? Let's assume you want to be liked. What can you do? I'll give you the answer with an example. Real life example. You know, there were these three guys in my school days. The 12 years I spent in my school, Sarja Indian School in Sarja. These three boys, I will not give you their identity because I don't want their privacy to be, you know, invaded. But let's say R, N, this is the first alphabet of their names. R and N A. Okay? These three guys were considered to be like the sex symbols, like the gods in our class and in our school. And as we move towards being seniors in the 12th standard, oh, this guy, N, he was like a sex symbol. Every girl was crazy about him. Every guy wanted to be like him. Everyone, you know, when he would walk, everyone would flock around him. He was that popular. The second guy, R, okay, put B also in that. There's another guy, B. R and B were like the gangsters kind of thing. You know, they always used to fight and all that. But they were good guys. They were good guys, but they had gangs. They were the gang leaders, so to speak. And man, you know, people wanted to hang around with them, be around with them. You know, it was like they were the, you know, they are the alpha male personality. They were not very muscled and all that, but fuck, nobody wanted to mess around with them. So they were another group. And finally, this guy A in my class, this guy was like the chocolate boy. Oh, girls would drool over him. They loved him. They were crazy about him. They just wanted him. You know, it was like he was an object of desire. So these guys were there, and I always wanted to be like them. Oh, I wanted to be popular like them, as not the gang leader, but I wanted to be like either. Actually, my favorite was being like this chocolate boy who girls wanted. I always wanted that. Or this boy who was like N, who was admired by every boy, every girl, who people would run like a celebrity star. Okay? Sadly, I never became any. And I'll tell you, you know, the biggest disappointment was he ended up being the leader of the school. Okay? The head boy. I also wanted to be something. You know, you get the lowest rank, the head boy, then house captains, then house assistant vice captains, then lower than that, then prefect. You know, boys would hold the gate and this. So the lowest one was prefect, and they would get a badge. I always wanted to be a prefect. Okay? I thought at least, okay, if not head boy, let me at least be prefect. When I put my name, I remember this teacher in our class, his name was Murli. Fucking asshole he was. It seems when my name was put, he objected to it. The headmaster, Mr. Radhakrishna, even though he was the most strict, even though he was the most, you know, and people used to hate him like crazy, and I also used to hate him, but eventually I got to know he was a good man. He even put my name, but this Murli jackass fucking objected, and they dropped my name. It hurt me. It really hurt me that I couldn't even get the lowest position in my school. Okay. But this is me, you know, pissed off with that guy. Anyway, maybe what he did was right. Maybe I wouldn't have done the role properly, or I'd be careless. I don't know. So anyway, I never became. Now, from school days, you finish your school at the age of 16 or whatever. Today, it's 44. Let's say 30 years. Now, 30 years have passed by. Now, how are those very same guys? You know, this N, who I told you was the most happening guy. Girls used to come, guys used to come, and he was like the, like a celebrity star, like a Hollywood A-lister. He got married, he had children, he has children. Normal guy. He's not uber popular, he's not uber famous. He's a normal guy now. Normal guy. There's nothing outstandingly great about him. Normal guy. Okay? Those two gangsters who I told you about, like rough tough guys, one of them became a highly respected banker, became a director. He turned out to be very popular in his circle. He knows how to play the, how to play office politics, how to play the power card, how to be a businessman. Very smart guy. Very intelligent. The other guy, B, he turned out to be more like a family man. Settled down. Didn't bother much. He has a small circle of friends. And then that chocolate boy, A, unbelievably, he just is one of, at his career is a fail. He's working in a very ordinary position. His was the most shocking. Let me put it that way. He has put on a lot of weight. He doesn't look nothing like those days. Very ordinary guy. Very, very ordinary. I mean, if you look at him, you wouldn't even say he's a chocolate boy. You'd say, who's this old man? Just like when people look at me and say, fuck, look so fucking ugly. Now, the funny thing is, after my school life got over, and obviously you meet people from the school, they bump into you. I was told by some of the girls and guys that, you know, you are so handsome. And I was like, wow, okay, I never knew I was handsome. But in hindsight, that popularity, that fame that was there in school, what I realized was it didn't matter. It really doesn't matter how famous you are with your friends, how popular you are with your friends, how much people surround you, crowd you. Because later on in life, all this doesn't matter. What I did realize is the only thing that matters is, one is your ability to earn money. Second one is the ability to sustain and survive and thrive. Survive and thrive. It's not just survival. Next one is how you're able to handle yourself and your family. And yes, your work and family. These friends and this and that, they come and they go. And you'll realize that unless you're in a political position, unless you're, you know, politics or you're in some corporate world right at the top, popularity and fame really don't matter. The reason why I'm bringing this point out is there are so many youngsters, so many people who are literally dying to be popular, famous, liked. I'll tell you, the fans and followers that you'll get, the friends and whatever, it's all like a temporary thing. It's like you pay a lot of money to get this. Let's say, for example, they give you this ice towel and you put it and you feel, ah, so nice. But after a few seconds or a few minutes, the towel is no longer cold. It's not iced. The experience is over. It's like going to play a game. You play a game on the slot machine. You played it. And it's over. Then you come out of the high. So same way, this friends and popularity and all that is very temporary. And as you grow older, you'll realize this popularity, fame and all that is highly dependent on, number one, how much money you have. Number two, how much power you have. Third one is how useful you are to that person who wants to take advantage. Otherwise, nobody gives a fuck. And the best example for this is, see, today I have so many followers and fans, whatever. I have fans, followers, whatever you can call them. But 2011, if you actually check, when I was poor, when I had no money, no food to eat, no place to stay, nobody cared a fuck. And I can assure you, if tomorrow I don't have a YouTube channel, I don't have money, I don't have fame, I don't have my health, I'm bedridden somewhere, nobody will give a fuck. Nobody will care a damn. So overall, what I want to tell you is, if you're not popular, if you're not famous, if you're not liked by people, don't let that bother you. Seriously, don't give a fuck. The only thing you focus on, the only thing you think about, should be your skills, should be your ability to make money, and it should be your family, the like your wife or your spouse or your children. The rest of the world don't give a damn, because people come, people go. And it's seriously of no use to you. Okay? And why I wanted to share this is because there are so many youngsters, so many people who try their level best to be popular, famous, liked. I'll just conclude by telling you this one thing. All the greatest minds, all the greatest personalities of our generation, all these people, they were never popular, they were never liked, they never had many friends. They spent their time alone, and that's how they grew and became better individuals. So don't try. You can either choose trying to please everyone or achieving greatness for yourself. So ask yourself what matters. Having said that, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. It's me signing off. Guys, take care.
Yeah, yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.